Hello, everybody. E here. Welcome to the first episode of Shorties. No. I don't know if I'm going to call it that or not. But I wanted to go through Scribe's short story stuff. They usually do a one-off by a popular author. And today we're talking about Chuck Palahniuk's People, Places, Things. I grabbed this one because it was short and I wanted to read something quick. I also wanted to read something non-fiction, and I'm glad I did pick this one up. And yes, I'm kind of stealing. If I make this short ease a series, yes, I am kind of ripping off Well-Read Beard, but he grabbed my top five Friday, so we're even. Anyways, no, Beard is a good friend of mine, so nothing but respect for him, and I like this idea, so I'm going to try it out. If you guys like it, let me know down there in the doobly-doo. If you want to read this story, it is free on Scribe. If you want a free month of Scribe and you want to help out my kids, for every free month that people sign up for, they get a free month. And no, it's not a sponsorship. It's just kind of like an affiliate reward program where they give me a free month every time someone signs up. And I have free months all the way up until 2025, so I'm working on getting my kids a nice little buffer, because they listen to Scribe for educational purposes and for fun. So it keeps them reading, keeps them happy. So if you want to help out, I appreciate you. Links down there in the doobly-doo. This one is very short. It's a short nonfiction piece. Short, I don't want to call it a short story, but it's a short piece of nonfiction. And it is about certain, you know, snapshots of Chuck Palahniuk's life. Of course, we're not going to go over character pacing and dread because this is nonfiction. But I did learn some things that I didn't know. And the number one thing is, there is a section he talks about. I had no idea. Now, this might make some people uncomfortable because we're going to be talking about bestiality for a very, very brief second. But I unfortunately have seen the video, Two Men, One Horse. I've seen a lot of these things. You can call it research. You can call it just maybe abnormal curiosity. But I didn't know that the man who took horse cock to the colon in that video, after spreading mare pheromones on his booty, I didn't know he died. But he did. He did not survive. And people have told me since I started talking about Palahniuk's piece, that there's like a documentary about this, or there's an article or something. I can't remember what it is. I'm not sure I want to watch it. The video itself was disturbing. I only watched it one time. I was like, oh, that had to have hurt. Yeah, it hurt so much that the dude died. But Chuck Palahniuk, I've always noticed that he gives me these little tidbits of information, even in his fiction works, that I'm like, you know what? I never would have considered following up on that story. And that's what I took away from this one, is every single section, and we're going to talk about how the book is story is broken up here in a second, but every single section, I learned something a little bit new, or I learned something interesting. And if you guys can hear the train in the background, my apologies, this mic picks up dang near everything. And I won't know until Editor E starts working on it. But the story, the actual text version with the pictures is on Scribe also in text, so that you can read the book and look at the pictures yourself. What I thought was cool about the audiobook is because the photos and all the images are so important to what he's telling you, that he has the narrator describe each picture in detail, and I thought that was wonderful. I didn't feel the need to go back and look at the text version to look at the images, because the descriptions of those images were so spot on. He describes artwork, he describes I think his portrait, all different kinds of stuff he describes, and it's so well done. I'm not sure if Palahniuk wrote those sections for the narrator, or if the narrator did it himself. I'm pretty sure Palahniuk probably did it, or someone else, you know, that writes ad copy did it, whatever. But I enjoyed reading the descriptions of these pictures, listening to the description of these pictures. This is a very short piece. It's only 43 minutes long if you listen to it, and I listen at times 2 speed, so 21 and a half minutes. I had a lot of fun with it. I'm gonna give it 5 stars because it was interesting, it was entertaining, and I think it was the perfect length. I haven't read much of Palahniuk's Palahniuk's short fiction, not short fiction, but his nonfiction, but I'm probably going to go back and search it out now, just because I like the way he writes, and it may be a nice palate cleanser since I haven't liked his fiction. I have not read The Invention of Sound yet. That's coming up before the end of the year, though. It's probably going to be my next read. But so much for this being a short video. Beard does Shorts on Shorts, I believe is the series name. I'm not a huge fan of short fiction, but I like watching everything that Beard does. With me, I'm too long-winded and I ramble, as you can hear right now. So anyways, it's a whole last video you got today. Anyways, so have you listened to or have you read People, Places, Things by Chuck Palahniuk? If you have, let me know down in the doobly-doo whether or not you loved it, you hated it, you felt meh about it. If you felt any of those things, let me know in detail so that we can have a discussion. But until next time, I have been E, you have been you, this has been another book review. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye!